Welcome back to another video of Fun Learning with Smita. In my previous video, I introduced a new application called as Pro Profs to you all. And as I told you, it's a wonderful application and it's actually a platform which gives you a lot of facilities to be explored. So in the upcoming videos, in each and every video, I'm going to tell you which all facilities are provided by this application. In my first video, that is Pro Profs Part 1, I showed you how to create a quiz in this application. In today's video, I'll show you how you can create a poll for your students or employees in the corporate world. So without wasting the time, let's get started. So the first step, as usual, is to type Pro Profs in your Google tab. And as soon as you type that, you're taken to the dashboard. And then click on the option product and click on the option all products. So when you click on the option all products, you are directed to a screen where they show you all the facilities and products provided by this application. So as we want to create a poll, I'll click on the option polls over here. As soon as that is done, you would be taken to a dashboard or a screen where all your polls are there. So you can see there are two polls which have been created by me. So to create a poll from the scratch, you can click on this option, that is create a poll. Again, create a poll. Okay, so on this dashboard, you can see like any other application, they show you a lot of templates over here, ready-made templates. There are many subtopics, whether you want business related, politics, sports or lifestyle. Once you select the subtopic, you will get some preference over here. If you think you want somewhat like that, you can select it. To just have a look at it before selecting, you can click on the preview option. So this wonderful application shows you how it would look, how the poll would look to your students on laptop, on a cell phone screen, and a cell phone with a sleeky screen. If you want to use the template, you can use the template and just share it directly. So there's no hard work. If you directly get any poll over here which is ready made, you can do so. If not, and if you want to start from the scratch, you can click on the option create your own poll. That is the first option over here. So I have just clicked it, and you can see over here they are asking you for some information. So you will type your poll question over here. For example, my question is, with due respect to the current COVID situation, if I want to ask the students or their parents that will you give consent to your child for attending the physical offline lectures? That's my question. If you want to add on any description, turn the notification on and write a one or two description over here that why are you conducting this poll. So I'll just write the description over here. This poll is conducted in order to know about the opinions of the students' parents or guardians, so that the school can take further decision. So something like this you can write as a description. Then you can see some options are over here. So obviously this question would be having only two options, that is yes or no. So I'll just write yes and no over here. I don't want option 3 and 4, so I'll just use the dustbin option over here and delete those extra options. If you want to add a new option, you can click on new option and you can see a new option pops up over here. I don't want it currently. Next is whether you want multiple choice question, checkbox. Now, as soon as I click on checkbox, you can see there are checkboxes over here. Whether you want it to be an essay type question, where you want some sort of comment or you want the writer or the person who's filling it to write detailed answer, then you can select this. So I'll stick to multiple choice for now. Once I'm done with that, if you want to add some image along with every option, you can turn this on. and you can see automatically some image options are there over here. So I'll just click on this. So there are certain emoticons already there. You can click on that, or you can upload it from your computer library. So if it's, I'll just show you the gallery. So for now, for yes, I'll just click on this and I'm done. So you'll have this beside your option. For no, I will be selecting another application, emoticon, that is this one, and I'm done. For the question, if you want any any emoticon to be used, you can do that as well. For example, this one I'll use. So once you're done with the poll, then you can save it, and it directly gets saved in your poll library. Okay, I've already created a poll using the same name. So I'll just change the name. Okay. So I'll just take you directly to my gallery so that I can show you the polls which have been created by me. So I'll click on my polls, where I will get all the polls which have been created by me. It's loading. Okay. So you can see the first one. To have a look, I'll click on the option preview, and you can see this, how wonderful the theme looks like. What's your favorite coffee? Images are there which have uploaded from my library, and options are there. As soon as the students click, they will have to click on the option vote as well, and the response goes to the teacher. I'll show you one more. The second one, the preview. Okay, for here you can see it's a very simple one. Will you give consent to your child for attending the physical offline lectures? Yes or no, just click and vote. So if you do not add any images, it will look like this. Plain, simple and formal. So you know, how would you share this poll with your students? You can see over here the share option is there. As soon as you click on the share option, you get email, link, social, embed or print option. So for link, you can copy paste the link and send it to your students. You can even mail it directly to all your students, or you can share this link on social media sites as well. As simple as that. And as soon as your students start filling it up, you will find it over here. So like you can see, two people have solved this, but there are two reports over here. That's it. How simple is it? Isn't it? So I have explored this aspect of ProProf's app to you all. So if you want to create a poll, you can use this particular application for creating a poll. So looking forward for another video with you all, where I would be teaching you another aspect of ProProf's. Till then, stay tuned, do like, comment and even share my video. Thank you so much.